Georgia Public Broadcasting presents the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Championships. Major funding for this program is made possible in part by IBEW Local Number 613, South Trust Bank, Georgia's Electric Membership Corporations, Dodge, State Farm, and by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Live from the arena at Gwinnett Center, it's the 2004 GHSA 5A Boys Basketball Championship featuring the Tift County Blue Devils and the South Gwinnett Comets. And welcome again, everybody, to Championship Weekend here on GPB. I'm Jim Giannacchio. Three great games earlier today, and now another big one ready for us here on GPB. The Blue Devils come in unbeaten at 28-0. The Comets of South Gwinnett at 30-2. The Blue Devils, of course, won a championship back in 1996, so they are looking for their second. The Comets are looking for their first. To call it courtside is Charles Ward and Herb White.
And thank you, Jim, and we're looking forward to some good basketball action in this 5A matchup featuring the Comets of South Gwinnett and the Blue Devils of Tift County. Charles Ward, Herb White with the play call. Herb, another spectacular ball game on tap. We expect a fast-paced contest between these two teams that like to get it up and down the floor.
Well, I think South Gwinnett probably likes to get up and down a little quicker than Tift County. Should be a good matchup because South Gwinnett has a lot of talent. Two of the better players in the state, if not the country, is juniors. And you got Tift County is a very balanced senior team. They've got five seniors in the starting lineup. They're very well coached, very disciplined. So they're probably going to try to slow it down and control the tempo. And here's one of their seniors now, not one of the leading scorers, but Thomas Hightower is a guy that averages about 8 points a game. But look at that field goal percentage for a guard. Plays really guard. They got him at forward guard, but almost 60%. And there you saw him against Lithonia in the semifinals. So this is a guy that really can stroke it from outside, and they're going to need him with that jump shot tonight.
So indeed, Hightower will be the key for the Blue Devils if he can get free. As we take a look at the starting lineup for the Blue Devils, it'll be Tolbert at the forward spot. Brownlee, he's the scoring leader for the Blue Devils. The rest of the crew, Dowers in the middle, Hightower, the one of the guards we talk about, Phillips, the other for the Blue Devils of Tift County in this 5A matchup. We talk about the other side of the ledger now in the Comets of South Gwinnett. Robert Moore, I'm sorry, the head coach of the Blue Devils of Tift County. His first year, great start, 28-0 in his first season. Can't ask for much more than that for head coach Robert Moore and Tift County. Now we go take a look at Lewis Williams, the guard for the Comets of South Gwinnett, and the Blue Devils will have their hands full with him, Herb.
Well, you got that right. Lewis Williams, the stats don't tell the whole story. Unbelievable stats. He and Mike Mercer, both great players. Lewis Williams can elevate probably as well as anybody in the country at about 6'2". He'll put both elbows over the rim, and you can watch early. There you see the points he scored against Beach the other night, and about a third of those were on spectacular dunks, and they'll try to get him an alley-oop early to get this crowd juiced.
Comet starters look this way. Backcourt joining Williams will be Mike Mercer at the other guard. Up front is Jukes at the center position. The forwards, Howard is one of the forwards, and Delano the other. Head coach for the Comets, Roger Fleetwood, in his fifth year at South Gwinnett, as we kick it over to the PA announcer, David Wethrow, with our starting lineups.
At guard, number 20, Thomas Hightower. At forward, number 21, Stanley Brownlee. At guard, number 23, Michael Phillips. At center, number 24, Antron Dowers. And at forward, number 25, Dwight Tolbert. The head coach of the Tift County Blue Devils is Robert Moore. Now let's meet the starters for the South Gwinnett Comets. At forward, number 3, Delano Howard. At forward, number 14, Greg Lockett. At guard, number 23, Lewis Williams. At center, number 24, Avery Jukes. And at guard, number 33, Mike Mercer. The head coach of the South Gwinnett Comets is Roger Fleetwood.
We have the starting lineups of both squads. We get set to tip it off from the arena at the Gwinnett Center. Coming up, it's the Comets of South Gwinnett and the Blue Devils of Tift County. Coming your way after this.
GPTV is Georgia Public Broadcasting, a member of the Georgia Public Broadcasting family of services dedicated to providing programs that educate, inform, and entertain. GPB, your PBS station.
Self-realization means that we have been consciously connected with our source of being.
Join Dr. Wayne Dyer for his newest PBS special, The Power of Intention.
This Sunday and Thursday on Georgia Public Broadcasting. And don't miss Dr. Wayne Dyer live in the GPB studios Thursday night at 7:30.
Broadcast of today's games is made possible in part by the following.
They're talented, tough, and almost perfect. Atlanta IBEW Local 613 supports education in Georgia and educates students through our apprentice program. IBEW Local 613, participating in education for the future of Georgia.
South Trust Bank is proud to be a longtime sponsor of Prep Sports Plus and the GHSA Boys and Girls Championships on Georgia Public Broadcasting. With more than 115 financial centers in Georgia, South Trust is proud to be a part of your community.
Around the block, just up your street, we're the neighbors you should meet. We live where you live. We're a good friend who really cares. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
State Farm is proud to be a sponsor of the Georgia High School Association. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Patti LaBelle hosts an all-star lineup, uniting the superstars of 70 Soul on PBS.
Everybody say house.
Sunday at 9 on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
We are back live at the arena at the Gwinnett Center, getting set to tip it off for the 5A matchup. But before we do that, let's go courtside. John Nelson. Nelly.
Thank you, Charles. Let's talk about the two extremes with the head coaches a little bit. Roger Fleetwood, 32 years of coaching, first time he's ever been here. He says he hasn't even had the opportunity to enjoy it yet. And for Tift County, Robert Moore, he was coaching junior college in Tifton at Abraham Baldwin Agricultural. Wanted to stay a little closer to home. Got the job at Tift County. And you see what he's been able to do. And he's going to try and fight what he perceives to be a bit of a North Georgia bias. He's not getting any respect. He's going to try and get that here today. And now the Tip about ready to go. One last thing. Tifton says the only thing there, practice, practice, practice. Let's see if they got enough practice in the books.
Okay, Nelly. Practice is over. We're getting set now for some real game action. The winner is 5A state champs of Georgia. Dowers. Correction, it'll be Tolbert jumping for Tift County against Jukes for the Comets of South Gwinnett. The Comets control first. Howard out front. Tough pressure already by the Blue Devils to Tift County. Right side Williams with the runner in the paint. Nicely done by Williams to get us started.
He's got the whole package, Charles. He can leap out of the gym. He's got a feathery touch. And, man, this kid can throw some nice passes.
He beats you off the dribble as well. He did it there for the first two of the contest. Tift County back the other way. It's Phillips. Misses on the jumper. Left side they go now. Mercer with his first offering behind the arc. It's off the mark. Fought for on the inside. Comes clear to Lockett. Lockett over to Mercer. And Mercer misses. Blue Devils now on their end of the floor. They work it right side. Tolbert handles it. Give it on the inside. Nicely done by Hightower for the lay-in. We highlighted Hightower in the pregame show, not because he's the scoring leader, but because he's going to be so critical for the Blue Devils if they are to win this ballgame tonight, his first two of the contest. inside and Trotty alley-oop and expect to see a lot of that. They were going inside to Williams with the pass was Aaron. Now it's loose on the floor and Phillips controls to Tift County.
Yeah, you know, I'm sure Coach Moore told his guys, hey, Lewis Williams is going to go up and throw down some nasty dunks on you before the night's over. They only count 2 points. Just let it go. It's going to be a basket.
If you could take the crowd out of that, then right. that's a good lesson.
Well, you just don't want it affecting your players, and sometimes you can almost become demoralized when a guy's playing at about 11 and a half feet.
Absolutely. As Phillips turns it over on the travel violation, Comets have it back the other way. Powered inside to the block goes Williams.
Well, that's what happens. They're going to run that man-to-man pressure. South Gwinnett is a great backdoor team. They will explode to that basket, and if you're overplaying them, you're going to give up some of those.
You look at them to spread the floor. That's what they've done. A couple trips down the floor that resulted in baskets. Tift County now there in the floor. Hightower handles out behind the arc. Up top to Brownlee. On the move, left side. With the jumper. Nicely done, but he missed. The rebound goes to Jukes and the Comets. Williams behind the arc for three, and he drains it. He works it on the inside, and he spots up with the triple there.
Well, Tift County's not the kind of team that's going to get shaken. They're a senior team. They're going to have to be careful, but they're going to run their offense. They got a very smart, well-disciplined team.
You're right. They trailed it in the semifinals to Laconia as we come away with the steal by Williams. Williams got the layup, but it fell off the mark, and he was fouled. So he comes away with the steal. And going to the line, or correction, it was Mike Mercer that got the steal, and he'll go to the line as you take a look at the replay.
Well, Lewis Williams is going to go to the line.
You're right.
Well, yeah, this is a very, very explosive team, South Gwinnett, and explosive teams with a lot of talent. If they do get the lead and get out front and can play a little looser, then they can be very, very difficult to catch.
Williams misses on the first of two. A couple of substitutions for the Blue Devils.
But this
Lynn
is far
Bryant.
Far from a two-man team, Charles. I mean, Mercer and Williams, again, both great, great players, but they're a very solid club all around. They can go to their bench two or three deep as well.
Williams gets one of two from the line. Comets leading at 8-2 over the Blue Devils. Backcourt now Cullens. And Cullens picked up up front and working at left side. Brownlee in the corner. And over to Tolbert. Colbert double-teamed, and there goes the steal by Mercer. Mercer, left side, he goes to Williams. Williams downloaded to Wayne Delano. Shot swatted inside by Colbert, but the steal comes back to Delano Howard. Howard gives it over to Mercer with the jumper off balance. Basketball goes out of bounds. It'll belong to the Blue Devils. Timeout taken by Coach Robert Moore.
Yeah, he's not liking what he sees. They haven't gotten a really good shot down there on the other end. South Gwinnett with a lot of quickness defensively.
So the pace up front with 4:50 remaining in this first quarter belongs to the Comets of South Gwinnett. Lewis Williams, jump start here in this ball game. The fine display thus far on offense.
Delano Howard, they've assigned him the task of getting on Thomas Hightower and making it very, very difficult for him to find any daylight. When you see him shoot, he's got one of the purest strokes, great spin, nice arch. You're going to make it very, very difficult for him to get the ball and get an open look. Lewis Williams, actually, as a freshman, Charles, I think averaged 31 points a game, so he's dropped down a little
just
bit.
Just a little bit, huh?
Mike Mercer's starting to come into his own because he can put him in the hoop, too.
Williams just a junior. And so is Mercer.
And the really good news, Bulldog down.
So far. Right side. Tolbert handles down at the block. They got an easy one. Brownlee was free.
Got to have some offside help with the defensive man fronting. They didn't get it.
Talk about that senior squad at Tift County. They were patient that trip down the floor. They got the easy basket. Left corner, Williams on the move. Spinner at the block. It's off the mark, but the rebound comes clear to Lockett. Whistles down low.
You know, Robert Moore over there hollering for over the back. Looked like it might have been, but they didn't make the call. Here you see it.
It was Lockett, the junior, inside. And he was fouled. He'll go to the line. Lockett on the season. Just over 5 points per ball game. And almost 5 rebounds per contest. The lefty hits the first free throw. Take a look at some of the crowd here. Near capacity in the arena at the Gwinnett Center. as Lockett gets to second. Sauce Gwinnett's first trip to the state finals. As they tap it away, the Blue Devils trying to get it inside to Brownlee, but good defensive work by Lockett.
Nothing fancy about South Gwinnett's defense. They pick up across half court and just play good, solid man-to-man. Rely on their quickness and athletic ability.
Cullens, who had a great semifinal ball game for Tift County, works it right side. Bryant tried to dump it down low to Brownlee. Whistles inside. Basketball belongs to South Gwinnett.
Well, that's where they're going to have to make some headway, is down low in there. They got a little bit of a size advantage. Couldn't get it then, though.
So Lewis Williams coming up the floor for the Comets. Take a look at the early turnovers. Tift County with five. South Gwinnett about to make their first. And there it is. There's the steal. Up the floor. Coming right side with the reverse lay-in by Cullens, but it's off the mark. Basketball comes clear to the Comets. Right side behind the arc. Mercer for three. The Rattler hits the front of the rim, but it's off the mark. Hightower clears for the Blue Devils. Cullens, cross dribble inside the paint, across the floor, threw it out of bounds.
Well, Coach Moore doesn't want to see that. He knows his team has got to control the tempo and cut down their mistakes to as few as possible tonight, because they're playing against the team with the talent edge.
Well, you know how it handles for the Comets now. Comets, their second consecutive region title this year. Set the record for the most wins in the regular season with 27. As Williams fires from three-point range, he missed, but down low, fighting for the rebound on the inside was Avery Jukes, and Jukes got the two for the Comets.
Calling out a set play now. Coach Moore, let's see what he's got.
Up top, Brownlee. Left side, they go to Bryant. Brownlee on the lead. Blue Devils way away from the basket at this point. Moving to the inside, hanging in the air. The lay-in is good by Tolbert, and Tolbert was fouled.
They are really shadowing Thomas Hightower. You watch it off screen. Here's a nice play.
Tolbert just hanging there, and he just outhung Mercer, if you will.
But if you watch something when you get the full screen, Delano Howard is really all over Thomas Hightower. And other than that early basket, he hasn't even had a touch on the ball hardly.
So Tolbert converts on the three-point play. Averaging 16 points per ball game in the regular season. Back the other way now is Williams. Works it right side, Mercer. Mercer running jumper from 10. One-handed, nicely done by Mercer inside the paint. Under 3 minutes remaining in the first quarter. South Gwinnett 14, Tift County 7.
6'4 point guard can give you nightmares in high school.
Brownlee, right side, top of the key, they work at Mount Tolbert. Left side with the jumper, Bryant rattles it home. It's only two, though. Just inside the arc. Williams works to the right side, whistles out front. He was fouled by Donnell Cullens. Cullens trying to cover Williams, but Williams with a quick first step. As we take a look at the replay.
There you see it. He's really got that explosive first step, as a lot of leechers do.
They had Brownlee on him initially. That's the steal by Tift County. Cullens back the other way. Cullens with the lay-in for Tift County, and they cut into the Comet lead. Howard across the timeline. Mercer right side. Guarded by Hightower. Across the floor to Howard. Free. Got a square look at a three. Rattles it, but he missed it. Rebound fought for at the block. Basketball belongs to the Blue Devils.
Heard some folks comment if South Gwinnett does have a weakness, Charles, is sometimes they lack a little bit of intensity. And, you know, other players sometimes have a tendency to stand around and rely on Lewis Williams and Mercer's talent, and they'll lose a little rhythm sometimes.
Sometimes that can happen when you have two prolific scorers like that. And back the other way, Cullens gets called for the offensive push-off of Lewis Williams.
Williams is playing that quickness again. He can do it on both ends of the floor.
3-point lead for the Comets. Field goals thus far. Each team with 5 field goals. Tift County 5 of 10. South Gwinnett 5 of 11. Williams works it out top. Brownlee guarding right side. They give it to Mercer. Running jumper from 15, and Mercer getting into the scoring act. Nicely done on the running jumper.
Not the most perfect form of a jump shooter, but he's got good results with it.
Comets by five. Out front, it's stolen away.
Look out.
Took it away.
Oh, and he's with the stuff
for the Comets. He took it away from Cullens out front. Lewis Williams with a jump start here at the arena. 7-point lead for the Comets. Tolbert working it right side all the way through the glass. Got the lay in and he blew the foul.
Oh, that was just sweet movement there, Charles.
Tolbert, the senior, with a fine job of maneuvering inside the paint for the lay-in.
Took it past two players off the dribble with a nice head and shoulders fake and laid it in softly.
You see what he did with his semifinals against Lithuania, 21 points, 12 boards. As he misses on the free throw, but the rebound comes clear to Cullens. And Tift County with a chance at another basket. Approaching 30 seconds remaining first quarter. Up front, Williams guarding Cullens.
They're going to hold for one.
At 20 seconds now. Cullens, as Williams going for the steal, basketball stays with Tift County.
Some contact there. The ref's going to shrug it off, though.
And Williams rattling Cullens just a bit with his defensive work out front. Tolbert to inbound it just in front of us. 16 seconds remains. Out front to Cullens. Tight pressure by Williams. Top of the key, and there's the steal. Mercer walking at the right side, and Mercer gets into the dunk out. On the inbound play, Howard goes to the steal, fires up a three at the buzzer, but is off the mark. And a quick spurt right at the end of the first quarter, and the Comets leading it 20-13 over the Blue Devils of Tift County. We'll step aside for a timeout. We'll come back, and we'll start the second from the arena at the Gwinnett Center.
GPTV is Georgia Public Broadcasting, a member of the Georgia Public Broadcasting family of services, dedicated to providing programs that educate, inform, and entertain. GPB, your PBS station.
Patti LaBelle hosts an all-star lineup, uniting the superstars of 70s soul on PBS.
Sunday at 9 on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
Broadcast of today's games is made possible in part by the following.
The Georgia Dodge Dealers. Proud to provide Dodge vehicles and service for all of Georgia. And proud to support the GHSA and great high school sports programming on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
No matter where you go in our state, you'll run across one of Georgia's electric membership corporations. We're locally owned and operated, which makes our 4,900 employees your neighbors. And Georgia's electric membership corporations cover 73% of Georgia, with 159,000 miles of power lines, serving nearly 4 million people. So now you know who's energizing homes and businesses all over. Georgia's electric membership corporations.
Peter Yarrow, live in the GPB studios, Tuesday night on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
This is Georgia Public Broadcasting, your PBS station.
Back live at the start of the second quarter, 5A matchup. South Gwinnett leading Tift County 20-13 as we get set to start the second. Charles Ward, Herb White, John Nelson at sideline. Phillips handles up top to Tift County. They work it left side to Hightower. Hightower up top to Tolbert. Tolbert cross dribble left side. Now back behind the arc and firing a three. Shots short by Brownlee. The rebound's cleared by the Comets.
Well, Coach Robert Moore was over there pleading his case during the quarter break, saying he thinks he's letting the referees letting South Gwinnett get away with a little bit of physical contact against his guard.
Williams tries to dump it down low at the block. to Jukes, but he threw it too hard. Jukes on the inbound line. Basketball now to the Blue Devils of Tip County. Just underway, second quarter.
And it's a tough matchup for Michael Phillips. They've got him listed at 5'8". I'm 7'2 if he's 5'8", Charles. He's about 5'3", and he's playing against a guy with the long arms and great hops.
Right side, back door. There's the young man Phillips at the block, but the shot's off the mark. Rebounds fought for, cleared by Mercer. Quickly up the floor, they sprint it with the pass to Jukes. Again, Jukes at the baseline, steps on the inbound line. Basketball back the other way.
Well, Michael Phillips heard those footsteps coming from behind, got it off a little too quickly.
You see Coach Moore going to his bench. A couple of players getting set to come in next up ball.
Brownlee and Talbot really got to go to work for Tift County inside and get them some points in the paint.
Phillips works at top of the key. Looking for Hightower on the lead. Can't find him. Goes instead to Brownlee left side. Brownlee across the floor now. Talbot for three. Shots off the mark. Backside rebound, Lewis Williams and the Comets. Williams cross dribble behind the back. Thought three. Now dumps it in the corner to Delano Howard, who will fire the three. The rim is off the mark, though. Rebound, Tolbert. He'll take it up the floor himself. On the dish to Phillips. Down in the corner. Whistle on the play. Travel violation on the Blue Devils in the corner.
South Gwinnett's quickness really giving these Tift County Blue Devils some problems. They probably haven't seen a team with this kind of quickness before. And they've really got him out of the ribbon offensively, Charles.
Brownlee rattled in the corner there, commits to travel violation.
They just got to hang in there with South Gwinnett, stay in the ball game, and try to get their offense cranked back up.
7-point lead now for the Comets. They work it across the timeline. Howard out front. Bounce pass over to Mercer. Running jumper to the glass off the mark. Rebounds cleared by Tolbert and the Blue Devils. Comets are spreading the floor so widely on offense. That time a good defensive stop over and back by Collins. And the basketball belongs to the Comets. Lewis Williams forcing the pressure on Collins, and Collins commits the violation there. Timeout taken on the floor. No question about it, the Blue Devils a little bit rattled by what they've seen on defense from the Comets.
Well, that's what quickness will do to you, Charles. And Collins was looking up. He's seen how quick Williams is. His long arms, he can reach in and deflect the ball. He's trying to look up, see the floor, and keep an eye on Lewis Williams at the same time. Lost track of where he was on the court. And Coach Moore knows it's early in this ball game, but he's really got to get his guys back into this game, because right now South Gwinnett is pretty much in control.
Some of the fans supporting the Comets of South Gwinnett, and they'll have the basketball. 5:46 remains in this first half. Howard handles in the backcourt. Left side, down in the corner to Williams. Now up top, Mercer. Alley-oop to Williams at the block and hit the cylinder, but there is Williams for the tap. His tap's off the mark. They play above the rim. Tolbert finally clears for the Blue Devils. Bryant out front. Over to Collins. Collins, right side, spins on Williams. Shot rejected by Williams. Basketball's loose on the floor. Comes clear to Tolbert. Tolbert had it swatted. Got up a bad shot. Basketball comes clear to Williams again. Inside the paint. And a whistle called. Foul on Collins.
Well, I don't want to beat it to death, but once again, the quickness and athletic ability of South Gwinnett just wreaking havoc with the Tift County offense.
Taking a look at the replay there. There you see it in the corner. Tolbert trying to get that shot up, but it was hit in midair. Comets just not being denied, taking every opportunity to swat at that basketball. And they have got the Blue Devils out of sequence. Georgia Public Broadcasting has made it easier than ever to show your support for great local programs like our coverage of the GHSA Basketball Championships. Simply visit our website at www.gpb.org. It's totally secure, simple to use, and it takes just 2 minutes. And thank you for your support of Georgia Public Broadcasting. 5 minutes, 10 seconds remains in this first half.
Tift County, you can see they're trying to control the tempo. Every time they get a rebound, they hold it. They don't look to run against this team. but they're not really getting into their offense, and they've really got to get some play down low physical on the block. That's what you're going to have to do this South Gwinnett team, is be very, very physical with them.
Comets with it there into the floor. They run the weeds. Williams behind the arc for three. This one shot hard. Hightower clears the rebound, but a whistle down low. Foul was called on Avery Jukes, the sophomore, inside.
And actually, Tift County's kind of fortunate right now that South Gwinnett is not really stroking the ball that well on their shooting, Charles, so this really could be a big lead.
Good point. Comets not doing that well from the perimeter at this point. Door open for the Blue Devils.
And that's what I'm saying. Maybe not as intense as they should be. They've got the 7-point lead. They might could really take it out there if they really stroke their offense.
Phillips up top, Hightower behind the arc. Had a good look. Whistles down low, though.
But the illegal pick.
Colbert up top. They're trying to free Hightower, the 3-point specialist for the Blue Devils. They caught Tolbert that time. You look at Mercer and Williams, the backcourt for the Comets, touted as the best junior backcourt in the state of Georgia. Mercer on the runner, left it short. Rebound comes clear way out front to Howard. So the Comets get another look. Howard with the runner, banked it hard. And another rebound at the block. Shot swatted, finally cleared by Tift County. Gwinnett had three looks at the basket that trip, not able to put him down.
A lot of people think this is the best backcourt in since Southwest Macon with Jeff Malone and his partner.
Absolutely. On the weave, inside, it's Hightower to the glass. He clears, and he got the lay-in for the Blue Devils. They needed that. The other partner in that Jeff Malone backcourt was Bobby Jones. Back inside is Lewis Williams for the Comets.
Well, thank you, Charles. That's pretty nice. That was a great basketball team, maybe the best high school basketball team ever in the state of Georgia. Terry Fair at the center.
I remember that. They put us out of the tournament. Tift County back the other way. Hightower behind the arc. Got a good look, but he missed it. Rebound comes clear to the Comets again. Williams across the timeline. Right side all the way through. Streaks past the defense, and he got the lay-in. It will be a long night for the Blue Devils if they're not able to tighten up on Williams, letting him go coast to coast.
Yeah, smooth with a capital S, and he also has that really long explosive step where he can just eat up a lot of territory going to the hoop.
Whistles down low, had a foul on the Comets.
You may be old enough to remember this guy. I talked to a couple people the other night. Williams kind of reminds me of a guy I played against in the NBA, Dave Bing. He was about a 6'3 guard, had really great elevation, a nice jump shot, same type of body, and a little bit of facial resemblance to Lewis Williams.
I'll date myself and say, yeah, I do remember Dave Bing. Good player, solid player.
Great player.
Blue Devils work it up top. It's Tolbert for three. Missed it on the three-point shot. Rebounds cleared by Lockett. Blue Devils simply out of sync on offense. Mercer across the timeline. Cross dribble tried to get it up. The defensive work by Hightower. Hightower comes away with the steal for the Blue Devils. See if this sparks the Blue Devil offense.
Well, they had the advantage then. Sometimes you just have to go ahead and run. They could have had a layup that time. They had 4-on-2 and still were not going to run it.
Phillips on the weave. Works it to Brown. Down low at the block. They do what they do on the inside. Did it well. Colbert got the lay-in. Approaching 2 minutes remaining first half. Mercer to Lockett. Now Mercer penetrating. Running jumper from 15. Shot it hard. Rebound cleared backside by Brownlee. And here comes the push by the Blue Devils. Can make it a 5-point deficit with a basket here.
Well, they've had a couple of nice looks out of the last 4 trips down. They've had 2 nice executions, but right there, another illegal pick.
Brownlee trying to get some separation on Lockett, and he pushed off. A minute 44 remains. Coach Robert Moore concerned as South Gwinnett leads it 24-17. And Coach Roger Fleetwood in his 5th year. Momentum favoring his squad.
Second foul on Brownlee, and that's the 7th on the team. So Thomas will be shooting the one-on-one.
Lockett to shoot it. Missed on the first, but the rebound to Jukes inside. Jukes had it swatted by the Blue Devil defense. It's loose on the floor. On the inbound line was Williams. Basketball to Tift County. Take a look at the replay down low. Excellent defensive work at the block. Tolbert with the swat.
Well, Tift County get out of his first half within 5 or 6 points of South Gwinnett, Charles, knowing they didn't play a very good ball game. Maybe they're a little more accustomed to the quickness and then come out and close the gap in the second half.
In fairness to them, they started slow in the semifinal ball game as well. Down low, Brownlee's fouled. He'll go to the line. Minute 26 remains first half. Brownlee turned in a great defensive performance in the semifinal ball game. As you take a look at his season stats, 18 points. He, too, with a good field goal percentage at 56%. But in that semifinal ball game, he held Robert Dozier of Laconia to just 9 points. And you don't do that very often.
No, Dozier, a sleek 6'8 forward, also thinking about the Bulldogs. It may be famine next year, but about 2 years from now, Charles, to look out for.
Pretty hefty, huh? So Brownlee connects from the line.
Well, that's big. If they can stop here and then go down and probably hold for one, they're in good shape.
Right side Mercer up top. Walks it to Williams now. Cross dribble Williams with the jumper, leaning back, and he bangs it home. Shades of Michael Jordan on that shot. 26-19 after the two from Williams.
Tough to hold the ball for one against the quickness of the South Gwinnett team. Let's see what happens.
Under a minute remaining first half. Left side, Hightower. Now Bryant in the corner. Tolbert on the move to the glass. What a dunk by Tolbert inside.
Some authority there. That's got to fire up this Tift County Blue Devil team and their fans.
He was streaking. Back the other way, and Williams answers with a triple almost on the sideline.
Well, that just rips your heart out. You have a nice dunk, get things going your way, and Williams hits one from 29 feet.
8-point lead now. Phillips behind the arc. Bounce pass Hightower. He's got a 3-point look. Yes! Thomas Hightower, the senior, with the triple. 14 seconds. Clock running now to 11. 5-point lead. Let's see what Williams does behind the back. Down at the block. He's free. Got a man there. Good pass to Brandon Sims. Sims able to convert on the steal on the inbound play. And Howard gets the basket at the buzzer. And South Gwinnett with another spurt at the end of the quarter. They lead it now 33-24 as we go into the halftime.
Two mistakes right at the end of the ballgame. They shouldn't have been out there putting pressure on Lewis Williams. They should have dropped back in the lane, gave up the layup, and then not careless with the pass.
Let's go over to John Nelson, standing by with Coach Fleetwood. John.
Thank you, Chaz. Let's talk about that last 10 seconds of the first half. Big momentum shifter.
Yeah, it was. You know, they kept making runs after we got off to a great start, but we could never quite. We had three or four opportunities to really get away from them. We didn't do that. They kind of got back on that three. That was really going their way, and then we get 4 points in the last couple minutes.
14 minutes of kind of hiccuping offensively. The last two looked like Lewis and the rest of them were finally getting their stride.
Well, it's a state championship game. These 17-year-old kids, they're probably more nervous than anybody here, but they're busting their butt, and that's all you can ask.
Coach Fleetwood, thanks for your time. Charles and Herb, back to you.
Thank you.
As Coach Fleetwood, South Gwinnett, up 9.
Thank you, Johnny. 33-24, the Comets leading the Blue Devils. We will step aside for a timeout, and we'll come back with more from the arena at the Gwinnett Center.
GPTV is Georgia Public Broadcasting, a member of the Georgia Public Broadcasting family of services, dedicated to providing programs that educate, inform, and entertain. GPB, your PBS station.
Well, the night anyway. Saturday, March 13th, it's an evening of special March Britcom madness. Keeping up appearances followed by the funny ladies of British comedy.
That's just drat!
Mark your calendars for March Britcom madness. Only on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
Broadcast of today's games is made possible in part by the following.
South Trust Bank is proud to be a longtime sponsor of Prep Sports Plus and the GHSA Boys and Girls Championships on Georgia Public Broadcasting. With more than 115 financial centers in Georgia, South Trust is proud to be a part of your community.
Power this intense takes the power of giving, the power of partnership.
We are the IBEW.
We are Georgia's EMCs.
We are South Trust Bank.
We are the Georgia High School Association.
We value partnerships.
Communities.
Teamwork.
We value students, and that's why we value Georgia Public Broadcasting. Feel the power of giving. Join us in supporting high school athletic programming on GPB.
Patti LaBelle hosts an all-star lineup, uniting the superstars of 70 Soul on PBS.
Everybody say house.
Sunday at 9 on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
And welcome back to the arena at the Gwinnett Center. It's halftime of South Gwinnett and Tift County. The Comets lead it 33-24 as championship weekend rolls on Georgia Public Broadcasting. I'm Jim Giannacchio. There's a special show coming up on Sunday morning on Georgia Public Broadcasting. I'd like to tell you a little bit about that. It is the Love and Logic. Don't miss this premiere broadcast of an introduction to Love and Logic. It's every parent's dream to send their children into the world prepared to make a positive contribution. Love and Logic can help make that dream a reality. Live from the GPB studios, America's parenting expert Jim Fay will offer easy-to-use practical techniques and funny stories about building character in children and eliminating the stress from parenting. An introduction to Love and Logic, Sunday morning at 11 a.m. only on Georgia Public Broadcasting. One guy that we all love here on Georgia Public Broadcasting is John Nelson, and he's back in the principal's office. Hello, Johnny.
Yes, there is no detention quite yet. I am here with Barry Simmons of South Gwinnett. We'll start with Mike Duck over here with Tift County. Let's talk about what this week has been like for you. It's been a while since the school has been this far into the playoffs. What's it been like in Tifton this week?
Been fantastic. The town has been a great supporter of our young athletes. Our coaches and kids have done an outstanding job. Our student body has been absolutely wonderful, full of pride, enthusiasm. Sounds great. It's great to be here.
And I noticed that there's a lot of the student body here. How much of Tifton finally came to this particular game? Was it one of those situations where the last one out in Tifton turns out the lights, or what was it like?
The last one that left Tifton turned out the lights, and they're up here to support our athletes.
Now, let's talk about how things are at Tift County High right now. Is there anything going on right now that you'd like to focus on where Tift County's concerned? Is there things going on in Tifton that you'd like the rest of the state to know about that they may not necessarily know?
Tift County High School, Tift County Board of Education, we are doing a wonderful job improving our kids' test scores, moving them forward educationally, academically, and also athletically. We're very proud of our school system. We're very proud of our Board of Education and the support that our community gets.
Thank you, Principal Duck. I appreciate your time. And that's two separate words, Principal Duck, first name last, not Principal Duck. Let's go over here to Principal Simmons. Barry Simmons, talk about what life's like been at South Gwinnett. It's been a football school this year. You guys have been region both, but what's it been like with South Gwinnett this week?
Just been a great week at South, building on that success of the football team, being region champs. Basketball, our Comet crazies come out, and I'm sure you hear them all tonight. Great enthusiasm all week.
What about academically, and what has it meant for pride for the school outside of the Comet crazies? What's it been like to have this kind of a run for the school?
Being one of the older schools in Gwinnett, our alumni have gotten real involved. I think we have the best support of any school in the state of folks traveling to watch us play. And then also academically, again, the kids get excited, want to be present, want to participate, and it's just been fantastic.
Now look 5 years down the line. You'd mentioned that the school's about 50 years old and everybody's kind of sitting here talking about the other schools. What's it like to finally have people talking about South Gwinnett and Gwinnett County?
Oh, fantastic. Again, I think success builds upon success, and we've had that opportunity right now and hope to continue that throughout the rest of the year.
All right, I appreciate it. It is time for me to escape the principal's office and send it back to Jim.
All right, thank you, John. And I tell you what, he was talking about success. We've got a successful second half coming up between two great teams that are playing some great basketball. The Blue Devils and the Comets. South Gwinnett leads at 33-24. Back to Charlie Ward and Herb White.
Thanks, Jimmy. First half in the books, 33-24. Herb, let's take a look at some of the stats from this first half of basketball from the arena, Gwinnett Center.
Well, again, South Gwinnett, you know, Tift County is a very, very good shooting field goal team, and they're way below their average, shooting 43%. They're 1-for-4 from three-point distance, and their three-point shooter, Thomas Hightower, has had one look at it. Not many free throws for either team. The turnovers is the key. Again, South Gwinnett's defense has really been putting the pressure on Tift County's offense, and you see it with the 12 turnovers there, Charles, and they've converted a lot of those into slam dunks.
Take a look at Lewis Williams' performance in that first half, 19 points and 5 rebounds thus far. He's on track to have a big one as we take a look at some of these highlights from this first half of basketball.
And highlights as in high, the emphasis.
Tift County on offense, inside, weaving with the basket and the lay-in was Tolbert. Now back inside again, it's Tolbert once again at the block. On the move, Tolbert with the dunk. Tolbert with a lot of the offensive punch for the Blue Devils in that first half. But on this side of the basketball, this young man, Lewis Williams, provided the spark for the Comets with his first dunk of the ball game. Now here on the steal comes Mike Mercer, his counterpart in the backcourt, and he got into the dunking act as well. Now behind the arc, Williams drains the three. Just a good display by that backcourt of Williams and Mercer. And they lead it right now, the Comets 33-24 over the Blue Devils of Tift County. And our John Nelson standing by with Coach Morinelli.
Thanks, guys. Here with head coach Robert Moore. Let's talk about the turnovers. Obviously a big bugaboo for you in the first half.
Oh, yeah. I thought we turned the ball over too many times, and that gave them a lot of opportunities. They already got two great players, and if you give them more opportunities than they need, you're in trouble.
Now let's talk about things for you offensively. Kind of, there were starts and stops and starts and stops. Nothing consistent for you offensively.
Yeah, we got to be more consistent on offense and get ourselves some easy buckets. I feel good about this half, though. I thought we had two turnovers at the end that kind of hurt us. But my guys usually pick it up, and they never quit, so we should be fine.
All right, good luck for the second half. Thanks for hanging out with us. Charles and Herb, he's got a deficit he's got to take care of.
We'll see if they can do it as we get set to start this third quarter. But before we do that, we're going to step aside for a timeout. 33-24, the Comets leading. Back with the third after this.
GPTV is Georgia Public Broadcasting, a member of the Georgia Public Broadcasting family of services, dedicated to providing programs that educate, inform, and entertain. GPB, your PBS station.
Save the day. Well, the night anyway. Saturday, March 13th, it's an evening of special March Britcom Madness. Keeping up appearances followed by the funny ladies of British comedy.
That's just drat.
Mark your calendars for March Britcom Madness. Only on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
Broadcast of today's games is made possible in part by the following.
No matter where you go on our state, you'll run across Georgia's electric membership corporations. We cover 73% of Georgia with 159,000 miles of power lines, energizing homes and businesses all over. Georgia's electric membership corporations.
Teachers think they're talented. Coaches think they're tough. We think they're perfect. Parents think they're wonderful. Many high school graduates are going to college, but many others are not. Parents and students want a satisfying career, not a dead-end job. Atlanta IBEW Local 613 has an answer. Electrical and technical professional careers made possible through the AEJATC Apprentice Training Program. Are you ready for the future? IBEW Local 613 and the AEJATC.
Live in the GPB studios, Tuesday night on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
This is Georgia Public Broadcasting, your PBS station, serving Atlanta and all of Georgia.
We are back live at the arena at the Gwinnett Center as we get set to start the third quarter. Boys 5A championship, Comets of South Gwinnett and the Blue Devils of Tift County. Charles Ward, Herb White, and John Nelson with the play call. As you take a look at Lewis Williams, 19 in that first half, getting set to inbound it for the Comets. Pressure in the backcourt, Phillips applying it on Howard. Howard spins across the timeline. He works it at the post, left side, to Jukes. Now the give and go from Williams to Jukes. Jukes missed on the lay-in. Rebound comes to Lockett. He missed on his first offering, but the putback is good for the Comets.
Well, Tift County cannot afford to give over one shot to this South Gwinnett team, and that was a nice give-and-go by Lewis Williams there.
Phillips working at right side for the Blue Devils. They dump it down at the block. Nicely done to Brownlee, but Brownlee can't convert on the lay-in.
Oh, that's a killer. Got the, and that, they did just what they want to do. We needed some easy baskets, and you can't miss those.
And that lead now is 11. whistles out front. Michael Phillips, tight pressure on Howard, and he got him for the foul.
Yeah, he's got his hands on him. Evidently, Tift County coming out, trying to step up the defensive pressure. Michael Phillips trying to create something out there.
Just underway in the third quarter. And Howard handles in the backcourt. Letting a stack offense. They work it down in the left corner to Williams. Takes a look at the three, fires it, and he missed it. Rebound, though, comes away to Lockett. Everything bouncing right now for South Gwinnett as they get the errant shot and another look. Now they spread the offense. Phillips went for the steal. Howard in the paint. Runner from five. Shots off the mark. Basketball belongs to the Blue Devils. Lockett touched it on the way out of bounds.
Hey, you're right, Charles. That ball bounced right to Lockett. I think it kind of surprised him, but the bounces are going their way. Tift County's got to come down, run their offense, get some things inside. Maybe if they can get a couple buckets inside, they can open up something for Hightower outside. So far, they've been all over him.
Cullens has it stolen by Williams. Williams going back the other way, and he got the lay-in for the Comets. Cullens with all kinds of difficulty against Lewis Williams. Williams, the long arms. A couple of steals on Cullens already in this basketball game. Up top, Bryant now. Bryant back to Tolbert for three. Tolbert hit the back of the cylinder. Rebounds cleared by Williams.
Well, they're going to be in a world of hurt with their 6'6 guys shooting out there. And they need to get some help bringing the ball up the floor. They're trying to have their guard go one-on-one with Williams, and it's not working. They need to get some help in the backcourt to get the ball up the floor.
Mercer handles out front for the Comets. Behind the back on Hightower. Now to Howard on the move. Left-handed to the glass. Nicely done by Delano Howard. They've got the offense. The Comets do. They've spread the floor, and they are running it to perfection. We talked about the backdoor plays possibilities in the pregame, and that's what they're doing. Back the other way, raveling it at Brownlee. His shot's off the mark. Rebounds loose on the floor. Cullens clears for the Tift County, and they'll have one more look at it. Cullens all the way through to the glass. The spinner comes out. Rebound fought for. And down at the block with the put-in whistle as Tolbert's shot fell off, but he'll go to the line.
Tift County's not really getting good shots. A little rush. They took about a 17-footer after, you know, just a few seconds across half court.
Take a look at it down inside the paint. Not much contact there by A.V. Jukes, but enough to draw the foul.
Pressing a little bit. You can see it. You don't get those layups like that. You're just pressing a little bit.
Tolbert on the night, 8 points, four rebounds. Rattles and misses the first free throw.
And the rim unkind right now.
Tolbert transferred into the Blue Devil program from Coffey County. Sets for the second, and he got that one to fall. Williams across the timeline with a quick step right side. At the block, in trouble, up top to Mercer. Mercer on the run, dumps it in the corner. And down to the cylinder, with the shot goes Jukes, and he got it to fall. Even the mishandled basketball by the Comets down low results into a basket.
Dangerous time here. Surprised Coach Brooks hasn't gone to a timeout.
Take a look at the field goals in this second half. Coming up in this third quarter, Tift County yet to convert on a field goal. And the Comets a perfect 4-4.
Well, when you're undefeated, Charles, and you get behind by to a team like this, you're not used to it. And they just don't know what they can pull out to get some easy shots.
Cullens will handle in the backcourt. We're approaching 4 minutes 30 seconds remaining in this third quarter. As Brownlee handles up top. Now Hightower. There's Tolbert. Tolbert at the block to Bryant. Bryant head fakes, got Mercer airborne, and Mercer commits the foul. So Tift County, they're able to work the offense patiently, and they found the free man inside the paint, but they've got to do a lot more of that.
Well, that's what they need to do for the rest of this ball game. That's the only way they're going to be able to stay in this game with South Gwinnett is to work the ball in the paint. They can't beat them with their quickness on the outside. They've got Thomas Hightower smothered. He can't even smell an outside jump shot. They've got to get the ball inside, work it, get a good shot every time, and convert.
Ryan converts on the first of two free throws. 41-26 lead for the Comets.
And Brian somewhere along there, also, Charles, excuse me, find a way to stop South Gwinnett.
That's been a big part of the formula, but it hadn't happened yet. As Williams works it across the timeline and bounced it right over to Collins. Collins in the backcourt, lost it momentarily, but it comes clear to Tolbert. Bounce pass Collins, now they kick it behind the block. Whistles on the play there. Collins out of control and runs over one of the Comet defenders.
Tift County not used to playing at that helter-skelter pace, and it shows.
So Phillips back onto the floor for the Blue Devils. And replaces Collins in the lineup. Marshall to Howell. Marshall lost it. Good defensive work by Phillips on the steal.
They need to convert some of these turnovers, Charles.
Phillips bounce pass right side to Tolbert. Running the weave offense up to Phillips. Cross dribble left side all the way through to the block. Dumped it down low to Bryant. He lost it. They don't convert. Turnover back to Mercer. Mercer in the Comets to the glass. Missed on the lay-in. The tap once. It's off the mark. Second tap off the mark. There's the third tap. That one's off the mark. And the rebound's finally cleared by Tolbert and the Blue Devils. They got a three-on-two. They kick it left side with the three-pointer. Brownlee, and he drains it.
Well, they needed that one. Three times down the floor, they didn't get a good shot. That time they drained the three.
3:15 remains third quarter. Whistle down low, basket by Lockett, and Lockett was fouled.
Defensive lapse there by Tift County. Left the man wide open under the basket. Turned his head.
On transition, Lockett gets the basket. As you take a look at the replay, Bryant was trying to get back on coverage, but too late.
Mercer and Williams both with that great court vision. If you get open, they're going to get you the ball.
Lockett trying to convert on a three-point play, and he does so. 43-29 now, Comets with the lead. Blue Devils with the basketball. Phillips across the timeline. Tolbert, bought three, thinks better. Now inside, gives it to Phillips. Phillips beat his man, and he got the lay-in.
Still don't understand. You got your 6'6 man out the head of the key, passing to a 5'3 man under the basket.
Low.
It worked there, but suspicious strategy.
It works there for the basket. Mercer back the other way in the paint, and he bumped Phillips inside. So Phillips, the spark plug for the Blue Devils, gets the charge foul there. And let's see if he's got something started for the Blue Devils.
Again, you see a couple trips down the floor out of the last three or four. They've made the mistake, South Gwinnett. Tift County's only got two baskets out of it to show for it. They really need to score off the turnover.
Tolbert out front. Brownlee looks for three. This one's going to be short. Rebound fought for at the block. Lockett had it, but he lost it out of bounds. It'll stay with the Blue Devils. .231 remains in the third. Phillips to inbound it to Hightower. Bounce pass up top. Brownlee maneuvers left side, running jumper from 15. Hits off the mark, and he runs down his errant shot. Now Tolbert for three. Tried to bank it, but he missed. Howard clears for South Gwinnett. Approaching 2 minutes remaining in the third. Williams left side all the way through to the glass. Banked it. He missed it. Rebound tapped around and tapped good by Williams.
South Gwinnett with those quick leapers keeping everything alive on the misses. They're getting two and three taps at it on every miss.
In the corner, they take it away from Bryant. Here come the Comets now. They got a two-on-one. Williams left side all the way through to the center. Got the lay-in, and he draws the foul from Hightower as well.
And you can see some frustration starting to show on the Tift County players. Lewis Williams just with a burst of speed. You saw him go by two guys at half court and take it and hang in the air and convert.
And he forces a timeout by the Blue Devils. The work by Williams will be going to the line after the timeout. Comets leading at 48-31. And right now, Lewis Williams and the rest of the Comets just having their way. You talked about the Blue Devils with some turnover opportunities, just not able to convert with a team like the Comets. You've got to take advantage of every opportunity. Haven't done so. Georgia Public Broadcasting would like to say a special thank you to our Morrow Society members. GPB's Morrow Society are the elite contributors whose commitment to public broadcasting ensures that we continue to provide quality radio and television programs to all Georgians. For more information about the Morrow Society at Georgia Public Broadcasting, just call 404-685-2581.
Well, Tift County's limited in their options. They're not the kind of team that can come out, put a lot of pressure on you full court, especially against a team with South Gwinnett's quickness. So they just got to get back in this ballgame the old-fashioned way, getting good shots, getting on the board, and they cannot continue to give South Gwinnett those second attempts at the basket.
Lewis Williams, the junior, tonight with 23 points, 7 rebounds, and has one block shot. Turning in a good performance. Has 30 in the third round ball game against North Gwinnett, 24 in the semifinal contest, and another 24 in the second round. On pace right now to eclipse all of that.
And all the starters coming back next year for the South Gwinnett Comets, so some coaches already wondering what they're going to do.
Had a little spill there on the Blue Devil sideline. Maintenance handled by the officiating crew, and we're set to begin live action. Williams trying to convert on a three-point play, and he does so. Phillips across the timeline for Tift County, works it left side. Ryan, putting pressure, works it out front to Tolbert. Down at the block, we're trying to get it to Brownlee. Brownlee's there, got it to the 7, and it falls good for Brownlee. Here comes Williams in the Comets, left side. Williams lost it momentarily, but able to get it down at the block with the pass to Jukes. Shot fell off the Jukes, but he was fouled.
Well, there you see South Gwinnett. They're trying to put some pressure on South Gwinnett in the backcourt. Williams just absolutely blows by two players off the dribble. And once he gets in the open court, he's going to make the right decision and find the open man or throw it down himself.
Avery Jukes, a sophomore, at the line. Rattles the first, and it pops out.
Also a good-looking young player. Jukes looks like he can add some more weight and size. Only a sophomore. This South Gwinnett team could be scary next year, Charles.
Jukes at 6'7". Converts on the second. A minute 12 remains, third quarter.
Like they're not scary now.
Really? At the block, Brownlee. Swatted from behind by Lockett. It's loose on the floor. Brownlee clears. Got a shot, he missed. A rebound to Lockett this trip for the Comets. Under a minute remaining in the third. Williams, quick step all the way through inside the paint, spins to the cylinder with the shot, off balance, but he got it to fall.
Almost impossible to guard one-on-one that high out from the basket.
Williams putting on a clinic right now in the arena. Left side is Brownlee. Up top, Bryant. Now Brownlee, left side, whistle. Shoving on the inside, he bumped Avery Jukes, and they get Brownlee for the foul.
Good defensive quickness again. Brownlee and Tolbert still getting most of their looks from outside, trying to force the action.
Mercer back on the floor for the Comets. Look at Coach Roger Fleetwood.
He's been riding the officials pretty good since about midway through the first quarter, but he, I think, a little frustration now. He didn't have anything to say about that last call. That was certainly an offensive foul.
26 seconds remaining in the third period. Delano Howard will inbound it. Blue Devils showing full court pressure. Up the floor with the pass to Williams. Williams slicing inside the paint for another basket, but they'll wave this one off. Williams with so much body control that time, flinging the arms, they get him for the foul. But take a look at the replay here. In between three players.
And it should have been a one free throw in a basket. The defensive player slid in there under him.
Didn't quite get there in time. But the break goes to the Blue Devils. 15 seconds remains. They work it left side. Brownlee for three. Air ball. Backside rebound. It's loose on the floor now. Howard had it, but he slid on the inbound line. It'll stay with the Blue Devils of Tift County.
Well, it just gets to be very frustrating, Charles, when you're playing against a team that is really that much quicker than you. And these guys have that deceptive quickness. They don't look like they're playing that hard. But, boy, they can just turn on that quick step and be by you. And then, as you say, they have the great body control, too, once they do beat you.
Collins to inbound it for the Blue Devils. Brownlee behind the arc, firing a three. Hits the front of the cylinder. Rebound comes to Williams. Up the floor to Howard. Howard at the buzzer. Yes! DeLeo Howard taking the headsy pass from Lewis Williams and converts on the three-point shot at the buzzer. Can it get any better for the Comets?
Coach,
what a play by Howard to end the quarter. 55-33, the Comets leading it. We'll step aside for a timeout, and we'll come back with the final from the arena at the Gwinnett Center.
GPTV is Georgia Public Broadcasting, a member of the Georgia Public Broadcasting family of services dedicated to providing programs that educate, inform, and entertain. GPB, your PBS station.
Self-realization means that we have been consciously connected with our source of being.
Join Dr. Wayne Dyer for his newest PBS special, The Power of Intention.
This Sunday and Thursday on Georgia Public Broadcasting. And don't miss Dr. Wayne Dyer live in the GPB studios Thursday night at 7:30.
Broadcast of today's games is made possible in part by the following.
They're talented, tough, and almost perfect. Atlanta IBEW Local 613 supports education in Georgia and educates students through our apprentice program. IBEW Local 613, participating in education for the future of Georgia.
The Georgia Dodge Dealers, proud to provide Dodge vehicles and service for all of Georgia, and proud to support the GHSA and great high school sports programming on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
Patti LaBelle hosts an all-star lineup, uniting the superstars of 70 Soul on PBS.
Sunday at 9 on Georgia Public Broadcasting.
You've waited months for it, and now it's finally here. On March 29th, it's Antiques Roadshow from Savannah. But before the big premiere, go behind the scenes for a rare look at the making of the roadshow in the GPB original special Antiques Roadshow in Savannah.
Louie. I'm gonna keep the day job.
Then stay tuned for part one of Antiques Roadshow from Savannah.
A rent!
It all begins March 29th on Georgia Public Broadcasting. And remember to catch the remaining episodes of the Savannah Roadshow April 5th and 12th.
This is how the Comets ended that third quarter. They lead it 55-33. They had an excellent play in that last play of the quarter. Take a look at it here. The time running out. Williams with the headsy pass to Howard. And Howard hoists the three-pointer to make it 55-33 as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter in this 5A matchup.
I saw Coach Fleetwood set up that play from the bench, Charles.
Did you? Diagram the whole thing. Cullens, right side. Down inside, and it's taken away by Lockett.
Well, the Comets in no hurry now.
Williams across the timeline. Left side, Williams head fakes to the glass. Left it short, follows a shot, missed on the second, still following it. Bounces it inside, taken away by Hightower. Blue Devils trailing by 22. Got to get something going early here in the fourth. Right side, Tolbert. Looking inside at the block to Brownlee, taken away by Lockett.
That's what you call telegraphing the pass, Charles. Textbook.
Tolbert there to receive the call. Williams back the other way. Howard out front. Three Comet players near the mid-stripe. Whistles on the play.
Well, he didn't penetrate to get a 5-second rule there at half court. closely guarded, you have to make the move to the basket. About the first thing South Gwinnett's run wrong in quite a while.
Coach Fleetwood there, had a quick look at him at the sideline. All these players now are going spread offense. Just trying to kill some time now. Hightower, the Blue Devils don't have that luxury. Out front, Brownlee fires a three-pointer, hits the back of the cylinder. The deep rebound chased at the sideline and comes down to Tobert. In the corner, Hightower for three, rattles it home for the Blue Devils.
Well, now you can see, just happened to get a fortuitous bounce there and got the wide open jumper. He's got the stroke, but I'm telling you, South Gwinnett was well aware of him when this game started, Charles.
Power. In and outside the arc, left side, lost it out of bounds. Basketball to the Blue Devils. 6:29 remains. Blue Devils, last state title. It's 1996 as a steal comes away to Williams. Williams right-handed and got the lay-in for the Comets. They extend the lead 57-36. Blue Devils, their own worst enemy in terms of getting back into the contest. Cullors inside the paint, dumps it over to Tobert. Tobert there for the step for the Blue Devils.
Well, I venture to say this is probably the highest turnovers that Tift County's had this year, and maybe by quite a margin.
Take a look at the replay. Cullens nicely done on the inside to Tobert. They need more of that. Out front, Howard being pressured by Cullens. Whistles away from the basketball. And a timeout taken by Coach Roger Fleetwood and the Comets. 5:50 remains. Comets. This is their first trip to the state finals.
Yeah, I think Coach Fleetwood is not really worried. He just wanted to get his guys over there, get them back on the same page, say, hey, let's play this thing out like the champions we're going to be. If we hang on here, let's execute our offense and let's play smart basketball.
5:50 remaining in this one. Let's take a look at what's on tap tomorrow with more state championships in the girls' Class A division at Savannah Country Day in Hawkinsville. That contest coming your way at 11 a.m. Then at 12:45 is Whitfield Academy against SACA. 12:40 contest for the boys. And in the 2A division, Westland plays Terrell County. That's a 3 o'clock tip-off for that contest. And the 2A for the boys, Randolph Clay versus Carver, coming your way tomorrow at 4:45 p.m. Then the 3A at 7 p.m. It's Gainesville versus Fannin County for the girls at 3A. That's all on tap tomorrow on GPP. Continuing coverage of the high school championships. Behind the arc, it was Brownlee for three for the Blue Devils. 59-41. And back the other way come the Comets. Whistles on the play. Blocking foul down low. Bryant tried to get there, not in time, as he fouls Jukes.
And an eagerly awaited game that Southwest Atlanta Christian Academy game in Whitfield Academy. Again, with a possible another number one NBA pick in about the fourth year. We had Kwame Brown a few years ago now. Dwight Howard, people saying he's going to come out, could be the number one draft pick in the NBA playing for Southwest Atlanta Christian. Whitfield Academy, though, a great basketball team, so that's going to be a heck of a ball
game. You're right. A lot of folks anticipating that contest tomorrow. The foul was not called on Bryant. Basketball belonged to the Blue Devils. They have it on their end of the floor now. Out behind the arc, firing a three is Brownlee. This one's short. Mercer tried to come clear with the rebound, but Phillips took it away. Now behind the arc, Tolbert for three, and Tolbert hits the three for the Blue Devils. 59-44. Williams quickly back the other way, runs the floor and rattles it home on the lay-in right side. They're just not quick enough to pick him up.
He's got to be around 40 points now, Charles. We get a look at what he's got, but he's got to be right there.
Back the other way, firing a three is Bryant. His shot is off the mark. They chase it down in the corner. Basketball will stay with the Blue Devils there to the floor.
32 for Lewis Williams.
Williams averaging 25 points per ball game in the regular season. 32 is highest in the playoffs. On the inbound play, Hightower got it to the cylinder for the basket. And a timeout taken by Coach Robert Moore after the basket by Hightower. They trail it 61-46.
Nice execution there. Here you see it on the inbounds play. And that's what you got to do again against the South Gwinnett team. And you look back during this fourth quarter and even about midway through the third and all the really bad passes that Tift County threw, Charles, and really it wasn't bad pressure. I mean, they threw three or four away trying to feed the post when they just kept looking and looking and threw bad lob passes inside. A couple of really weak passes out front here. You take those five or six turnovers back and they score on half of those buckets, then you got under a 10-point game here and you got a ball game. And still not out of the realm of possibility right now. A couple more threes and maybe they can get South Gwinnett to tighten up just a little bit.
Comets started out with a very tough defense in terms of pressuring the basketball, and that very well rattled the Blue Devils early on. And after they relaxed on the pressure, the Blue Devils never made the adjustment to take advantage of the easiness pressure. But you're right, that's an excellent point in terms of what happened with the Blue Devils. They've got to steal some out with 4:28 left to see if they can string something together.
Yeah, and you know, they had 12 turnovers at halftime. They probably have at least, you know, that many in the second half, and I would venture to say five or six or seven of those turnovers were really unforced. It was just poor execution.
After the timeout now, the Comets will inbound it left of the cylinder. Full court pressure by the Blue Devils. In the corner, Williams sidesteps the defense, and here he comes agilely into the front court. Dumps it down at the block to Mercer. Mercer dumps it over to Sims, who gets the lay-in for the Blue Devils, for the Comets.
Once again, excellent ball movement and excellent looks from Mercer and Williams.
In a full court press by the Blue Devils that ordinarily would work with most teams, Comets just too quick and elusive to get out of it. Inside the paint, Tolbert shots off the mark, but he gets his own rebound for the putback. There's full court pressure. Williams had it bounce off his leg. Tapped out of bounds. Good call by the official away from the basketball. Williams falling to the surface, able to knock it off of Brownlee. Take a look at the replay.
Great hustle by both teams there.
Ball off of Williams' leg. And look at that last play at the moment. Bounced off of Brownlee. They keep the basketball as a result. Nice work by the GPTV camera crew as well. Howard out front now. On the weave to Williams. Williams lost it inside the paint. Cullens back the other way. Spins inside and back outside the arc. Tolbert on the line for two. Shots off the mark. Rebound to Mercer. Mercer across the floor. Tried to get it over to Sims.
They put a little mustard on that one. Coach Fleetwood not real happy. He's going to call a timeout and talk it over a little bit. Get some discipline back on the floor.
3:24 remaining in the ballgame. Mercer with the basketball in the front court. Kind of lulled the defense to sleep there, but with the quick pass across the floor to Sims, Sims not quite ready for it. 63-48, South Gwinnett still with a commanding lead.
Yeah, I tell you, Lewis Williams can go in so many different directions so quick. He can go up in a hurry, he can go forward in a hurry, and he can go laterally in a hurry.
Mark your calendar for Friday night, March 19th, for the return of Georgia's longest-running high school sports and academics program, Prep Sports Plus. You'll meet some of Georgia's most successful student-athletes, athletics programs, and much more. That's Prep Sports Plus, returning on Friday, March 19th at 11 p.m., exclusively on GPB.
Charles, I'll tell you, the last player that I can think of that had the type of first step and quickness that you see out of Lewis Williams was Tony Aiken. You remember him?
Sure, played
up in Gwinnett County and then, of course, started at Georgia Tech. Tony Akins was a very quick player and had that great first step, but didn't have near the hops, of course, that Lewis Williams did, or the stroke. So, you know, it's just that little bit that gets that separation, the Michael Jordan type of first step, Kobe Bryant, and this young man certainly has it.
Williams with all the tools. Blue Devils have the basketball. 3:15 remains in the contest. Collins inside the paint, got it to the cylinder, but shots off the mark. Williams will clear for the Comets. Williams quickly to the right side, inside the paint, just forcing the action, and draws another foul.
He just accelerates past other players almost effortlessly. I mean, it's just a beautiful thing to watch. And Mike Mercer, who would be a superstar on any other team, of course, and he's about 6'4", and has that kind of frame, looks like he could fill out, maybe go to 6'7", and put on some weight. And then you're talking about a point guard that's really going to give people fits.
You said it a few minutes ago, talking about them next year, the Comets, they will be scary then, but right now they put a lot of fear in folks. And having their way in this championship ballgame thus far.
Yeah, you can't fault Tift County's effort. They've given it everything they can just up against a really, really talented team that's on their game tonight.
3:05 remains. Hightower across the timeline. Left side, Bryant. Bryant up top, Tobert. Head fakes in the paint. Tried to dump it down low. Does so to Brownlee. Brownlee got it to the cylinder. Shots off, but a foul call.
Would have liked to see some more of that action between the two big guys passing the ball to each other in the paint. I think they could have had some better results down there and gotten to the free throw line, because South Gwinnett really doesn't have the bulk to keep those guys away from the basket.
That's what we anticipated seeing from the Blue Devils, to work it on the inside with the bigger players.
Well, the quickness took them out of the ball game early, and they just never recovered, really, to get their offense back into gear.
That is the way you counter the bigger players on the inside. If you can rattle the guards out front and make it tougher for them to get the basketball on the inside. Take a look at Brownlee's performance. 14 points, 3 rebounds. And he gets the second. Under 3 minutes remaining now. Williams scooting across the timeline. Left side. Draws another foul out front.
Well, I know Coach Dennis Felton from the University of Georgia liked to put up a wall around Snellville to keep out all opposing coaches. I think there's an early signing period in October. Of course, the guys have committed, but they haven't put their name on the dotted line yet.
Foul was called on Collins. That was his fifth. So he departs as you take a look at Williams on the night. 34 points, 10 rebounds, and 1 block shot.
And I can't remember him putting up a bad shot in the whole ball game, Charles.
His best performance in the playoffs. Missed on the front end. The rebound's cleared by Brownlee. Basketball kick. It'll stay with the Blue Devils. That's Robert Moore, his first year at Tift County. Give him a lot of credit. Undefeated season. As Hightower fires a three-pointer. Calls nothing but air. Basketball belongs to the Comets.
Well, maybe we shouldn't have tipped off Coach Fleetwood about Hightower being the key to the game before the game started, because they really clamped him down. I think that was also responsible for taking the Tift Blue Devils out of their game, because he had been really playing well in the playoffs up until this game.
Williams in the backcourt. Now into the four. Down at the block. Bounce pass. A pass got there. He got it down low to Jukes. Jukes with the head fake. He drew a foul. They're going to count the basket. Say the interference by the Blue Devil defense. So it's 67-49 now. Comets with the lead. Take a look at the replay.
That's got to be a good feeling for a big fella like Jukes at 6 minutes, about 6'8", as a sophomore somewhere in there, 6'7", and knowing that Lewis Williams can go out and score all the points he wants to, but he's willing to give it up to you if you'll just work and get open.
And Williams with another phenomenal play at the side of the basket. Drew the foul, continued with the shot, able to bank it off the glass, and he'll go to the line. So just a stellar performance by Lewis Williams tonight. Absolutely no phase of his ball game tonight out of sequence.
And again, really hasn't forced the action, Charles. He's let the game come to him. He's played good defense. He's come up with a lot of steals. He's put pressure on the ball. Can't ask any more from the young man.
Williams converts on the three-point play from the line. 2:18 remains. It's been all Comets of South Gwinnett. Out front is Tolbert. Tolbert with the left hand. Nicely done, but he left the shot short. Rebound to Howard. Gwinnett with a 3-on-2. Left side he goes with the pass to Mercer. Mercer over the defense of Phillips for the lay-in. Acrobatic shot by Mike Mercer extends the South Gwinnett lead. Hightower right side to the glass. Shots off the mark. Believe Williams may have tipped it. Howard up the floor to Williams now. Williams right side, still penetrating in the paint. Now kicks it back out to Mercer. 1:30 remaining. Mercer is fouled out front. And Coach Fleetwood now going to take an opportunity to allow the fans to show their appreciation for his starting five. As we have 5 substitutions getting set to come in now for the Comets of South Gwinnett.
Well, nice move by Coach Fleetwood with 1:25 to go, and You know, South Gwinnett really didn't try to embarrass. They really didn't do anything. They just played their game. And they spread the floor, and they took advantage of what they had. But a very classy way to end the game, and I think Coach Moore is probably going to send in his bench as well.
Both sides conceding for different reasons to get the alternate players into the lineup.
Tough way for these seniors for Tift County to end their careers, but, you know, you can look back on a great season, and, hey, you just got beat by a better ball club tonight. Nothing to hang your head about. This is a very, very good basketball team, and they're only going to get better in the future.
Very well stated. Blue Devils with an all-senior starting lineup. So we'll say goodbye to most of that team from Tift County. It'll be interesting to see if Coach Moore can string it back together and make another appearance here in the finals next season.
Well, you know, when you get a good team and you make a run like this, inspires the younger kids in your town and in your county to go out there and work that much harder, and it tends to feed the, you know, the system and keeps it going. So, you know, when you got a good coach and you got a good program, and they certainly do, you look for those guys to have a good team every year as well.
Congratulations going out to Coach Roger Fleetwood. You saw him at the sideline, got his alternate players into the lineup. As the Blue Devils now work it out top, Ernest Taylor handles basketball. Over to Higgins. Now they give it back in the corner to Taylor. His shot's off the mark. Rebound's cleared by Mike Mercer. Mercer got a trailing man, dumps it down low inside to Jason Miller. Miller's shot is off the mark, but the rebound comes clear to Kyle Shepard. Shepard bounces back outside to Mercer. We're under a minute remaining. Mercer, running jumper in the paint, rattles it, and it falls good for Mike Mercer. So after the basket by Mercer, he too will take a seat. Chris Langley replaces him in the lineup. And Mercer gets a big hug from Coach Roger Fleetwood coming to the sideline.
Well, we mentioned it earlier in the ballgame, just a great, great backcourt. You got two guys to go one-on-one. They can bring the ball up the floor and beat the pressure, each one of them. They can make the play, taking it to the hole themselves, or they can dish off. So, you know, it just gives you so many options as a coach to have one player like that, let alone two.
And both, again, committed to UGA.
Yes, sir.
So the Blue Devils will have the basketball. As Reedy comes across the timeline.
Well, thanks to our guys in the production truck again, Charles. Another great day of basketball. Caught all that great action on the instant replay. Great camera work. Great calls out of the truck. And I'm just amazed by the hard work and long day that got those guys put in out there.
Class A matchup with our production crew. Couldn't have said it better myself. Back the other way with just 19 seconds left to the basket. It was Langley, and Langley was fouled. And always appreciate the opportunity to work with you, Herb. And a couple of good ball games you had on tap tonight with the girls and including with the guys.
Certainly is, and of course, Jim Giannacchio, the anchor of the whole show, doing it once more.
Indeed, you're right. John Nelson at sideline. Langley from the line, misses on the first. Did we miss anybody? I think we got everybody.
We just want those checks getting here early, don't we, John?
Langley converts on the second. And another full day of action coming your way tomorrow. We hope you'll be watching. Behind the arc is Streety. Down to 5 seconds. With the jumper, it's Johnson. It's off the mark. Rebound comes to the Comets. And there you have it. Comets win it 75-49. They are your 5A champs in the state of Georgia. That is the first ever for South Gwinnett. Just a dominating performance, both ends of the floor. And the result, they win the state title.
Yeah, Charles, you know, it's hard to say this team won't be back in the finals again next year. I mean, when you look at the talent they have on this team and what's coming back, there's a lot of great teams in Georgia. But you got to figure these guys are odds on. They can at least get back to this game.
They started from the beginning tip and just commanded the contest. Mostly through Lewis Williams, but you can't pin it all on Williams. Just a great team effort by the Comets.
Yeah, and then, you know, Tift County 27-28-0 coming into this basketball game. Had not lost a game all year.
And so just a very, very impressive win.
All right, John Nelson standing by with the winning coach, Roger Fleetwood. Nelly.
Thank you, Chaz. 32 years of coaching. That takes us back to the Nixon administration. You finally have a title. How does it feel?
And it feels wonderful. The kids are just such great kids, and we got a good team. We knew all along we could win this thing, and we put it in their ear from last May. You know, as soon as school was out, we started talking about winning a state championship. We were pretty bold in the paper at the beginning of the year and said, you know, if you don't think you can, don't say it. And we thought we could. We didn't think we were the only team that could win it, but we thought we were one of the teams that could win it.
You had a decent margin leading at the half. Third quarter, you really kicked it in.
Yeah, we did. Defensively, we really played great. You know, we get criticized all the time for being a showboat team that won't guard anybody and won't rebound. Well, I think we proved it in the tournament. We can guard some people.
And you've also got some shooters. Lewis Williams, Mike Mercer. Thanks for your championship. Charles and Herb, send us home.
Thank you, Nelly. 75-49 win for the Comets. You're 5A state champs in the state of Georgia, and they do it in fine performance, Herb.
Certainly did. I think the coach said it all. You know, this team, yeah, and let's don't forget, we got the first ever historic event. We're broadcasting the 2004 Wheelchair Championship, and wait till you see these young athletes in action in the morning on Georgia Public Georgia Public Broadcasting.
75-49, once again, the final score. Your 5A state champs, the Comets of South Gwinnett. Charles Ward on behalf of Herb White and sideline reporter John Nelson and everybody at GPTV saying thanks so much for joining us, and we'll see you tomorrow.
This broadcast of the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Championships has been made possible in part by IBEW Local Number 613, South Trust Bank, Georgia's Electric Membership Corporations, Dodge, State Farm, and by the Atlanta Journal-Constitution.
GPTV is Georgia Public Broadcasting, a member of the Georgia Public Broadcasting family of services dedicated to providing programs that educate, inform, and entertain. GPB, your PBS station.